Let's take a look at this week's hobby happenings with some news, notes, and nuggets about the hobby that you love. So we kick things off this week with a report on the sale of a baseball signed by 11 members of Major League's original 1939 Hall of Fame inductees. The ball, offered through SCP Auctions, sold for $623,369 last Sunday morning. It's a record price ever paid for an autograph baseball, and it has accrued in value tremendously because Christie's Auction House in New York first sold this treasured autograph piece in 1997 for a mere $55,000. It's quite a rate of return.
I'd say. Hey, Rob, you and I both know this, and they say this: behind every good man is an even better woman.
Absolutely.
Such appears to be the case as well for our friend Justin Barcombe of Kingsbury, New York, who, after recently losing his job, took a leap of faith and opened a card shop at the urging of his wife.
Nice.
Yeah, I know, right? So JB's Trading Card Company in Kingsbury, New York, will host its grand opening this Saturday. So if you didn't get out last weekend for National Baseball Card Day, you've got a great reason to go to the LCS in New York this week. Justin, or JB, has been a hobby veteran himself since 1987. He's a longtime eBay seller, and he has big plans for this. Breaks and trade nights. We here at Go GTS Live wish Justin the best of luck and can't wait to see the reports come in from the grand opening.
Absolutely. So how would you like to spend an evening with Wayne Gretzky, a.k.a. the Great One?
Let's do it.
Well, Steiner Sports is offering another one of their experiential events and is giving fans and collectors that opportunity next month. General admission tickets aren't cheap. They cost $600, but do include open bar, hors d'oeuvres, and a photo opportunity. However, if you want to come away with an autographed framed photo, in addition to the aforementioned benefits, you're going to have to pony up $1,500. Visit Steiner Sports for more information.
All right, let's go in halvesies, and I get happy hour, and then you get the dinner. If you're on the East Coast and you're planning to attend the East Coast National this weekend in White Plains, New York, you may want to take advantage of Beckett's grading special for the show only. The company will be offering a 10-day turnaround service of all pre-1981 cards for $10 with no minimum submitted. Pretty nice offer.
I don't want to, just to correct you a little bit, 10-day turnaround, $12 with no minimum.
Did I split that?
I think so. I don't want people going up there saying, yeah, but the also, guys at Go GTS Live.
Part of the issue is that I did find out Marley Shelton, who played Wendy Peffercorn, so uh-huh. We were both, it was right in the middle, is in the 2018 Topps Archive set as an autograph. So
sweet, thank you.
A little distracting there. Sorry, Beckett, you deserve the full 1981, pre-1981 cards, $12, no minimum, for White Plains, New York, East Coast National.
Awesome. with Mantle Mania raging since the sale of a mint condition 1952 Topps in April for $2.88 million, the display of a gem mint example worth $10 million at a Denver museum last month, and the pull of a 1955 PSA 9 on the main stage at the National, the recent record-breaking auction of a mint 1933 Gaudi Babe Ruth actually flew a little bit under the radar. The sale through Golden Auctions for $312 is big news for several reasons, because it reaffirms the tremendous rate of return for popular high-end baseball cards as an alternative investment. What makes this sale particularly unique is that it marked the first time that an iconic Gaudi Ruth card number 181 in a PSA 9 has changed hands since 2006. Also, because it's the exact same card that sold 12 years ago, so there can be no debate about subtle variations between two mint specimens, etc. So, As a result, this sale is able to show the exact upward trend over the course of a 12-year period. During that time, this mint Ruth has soared 423% from $73,000 to $312, which actually doubled the gains of the Dow Jones over the same period of time, which jumped from 12,000 points to over 25,000 points, an increase of just 210%. So for those of you keeping track at home, we can say as a definitive fact that in this circumstance that the value of this Gaudi Ruth card has more than doubled the performance of the Dow Jones Industrial Average during the same period of time.
Yes, Rob, but how is Bill Dickey's card from that set going?
I don't know.
Well, in case you haven't heard or seen, because you've been busy with other things, this week Topps released a lot of information that you want to catch up on. The first is images and early details for the design of 2019 Topps baseball cards. The company notified collectors via the Topps blog that the border colors will change based on the player's team and that parallel colors will be noted on the outside areas behind the border and in the white areas on the edge of the card. So if you've seen the design, you'll know what I'm talking about. In other Topps news, the company has announced the return of its once popular Topps of the Class program, which I think they deserve a round of applause for, because this is designed to get kids into the hobby even stronger. The concept of the program is simple. Kids are encouraged to bring their report cards to a participating hobby shop where they will receive a free gift simply for getting good grades. First introduced around 2006, the program ran for a few years and featured Topps spokespeople like, at the time, David Wright. Brody, the Topps kid, he's become somewhat of the Topps mascot since the National, actually helped make the announcement at Topps' annual Town Hall Q&A meeting at this year's National Sports Collectors Convention. Be sure to follow GTS and Topps as more information becomes available, because we want you to be informed so that as many kids can take advantage of this promotion as possible. But wait, Rob, don't cut me off yet. There's even more Topps news. That's right. Topps 3D is coming as part of the company's physical on-demand offerings. And you can tell how excited I am for this. 3D! I love 3D! The set is going to feature the top 100 cards from this year's Topps Baseball Series 1, 2, and updates. Utilizing 3D technology, these cards will display players in action. What does that mean? No one knows, but we can't wait to find out. Each pack is going to contain 5 3D base cards and 3 motion insert cards. Packs are available exclusively through the Topps website for the next 55 days or while supplies last. Cost $19.99 each with free shipping. Thanks, Topps.
Cool. Well, did you have your picture taken with an athlete or celebrity at the TriStar photo booth in Cleveland at this year's National?
I wish.
Well, TriStar wants you to know that you can now order extra prints and keepsake items of your favorite photos. Visit TriStarPhotoBooth.com for more information. Well, that Billy Ripken card is getting its own bobblehead. Yes, that Billy Ripken card. That infamous 1989 Fleer baseball card that ignited the hobby, sent panicked parents ransacking their kids' collection, and made the PMRC temporarily ignore D. Snyder, giving him a reprieve from the church ladies. That card that led to several different variations as the result of various reprints in production. Yes, that Billy Ripken card is getting its own bobblehead courtesy of the Hagerstown Suns, the Class A affiliate of the Washington Nationals.
Now wait, can we say what that card is, though? This isn't broadcast on...
Now, don't worry, kid. Kids won't be handed an F-bomb inscribed miniature of the younger Ripken, but instead this wholesome version. Thanks, Hagerstown and Beaver Creek Antique Market, for bringing back some great hobby memories.
Memories that continue to bring fun to the hobby. And finally, Rob, as if you really needed one more reason to love Twitter, how about this player-collector interaction that transpired on Twitter this week? After a collector expressed his disappointment with the autos he pulled from a box of Topps clearly authentic, fellow collector at MRJWOE,
Mr. J-Woe, yeah. Okay,
making sure I'm pronouncing it right, chimed in with his displeasure at pulling an Anthony Banda autograph. So, mine was worse than yours. I got Anthony Banda. Well, now Anthony Banda, a pitcher with Tampa, without ever having been tagged in the tweet, saw it and responded with the pictured sad-faced emojis. Dope. So, of course, feeling like a little bit of a tool, Mr. J-Wo replied accordingly in good spirits, and Banda, being the good guy he is, replied that it was all in good fun. As other collectors began to troll on and express interest in getting Banda's autograph, he actually encouraged anyone wanting a signature to send items to him in care of the Tampa ballpark. I love this story, and special thanks to viewer Alex Kent for bringing it to our attention. Nice job, Alex.
And that's a look at this week's Hobby Happenings.